My dear students, today is a wonderful day, a wonderful feast day on which to conclude our school year. Today is the final day of school. And as we think about the Sacred Heart of Jesus, we call to mind the words of our Lord Himself to St. Margaret Mary regarding devotion to His Sacred Heart. He said to her, "Behold this heart which has loved men so much, but is so little loved in return." And so what our Lord tells us by these words is that He wants us who do love Him, He wants us to make reparation. He wants us to console Him or make up to Him for so many people in the world who do not love Him, do not serve Him, do not obey His commandments, and don't care about offending Him. And so we want to be obedient to our Lord's commandments. We want to be faithful in our prayer life and thereby make reparation to our Lord. Now, you have all heard, I'm sure, the stories about the children at Fatima to whom Our Lady appeared. The boy's name was Francisco. And Francisco, who was only 8 years old when Our Lady appeared, took very much to heart the words of our Blessed Mother for reparation for sin. And he would spend many long hours repeating over and over again the words of the angel, the prayer that the angel had taught him, of adoration, of reparation. And the other children, the same thing, spent a lot of time to make reparation. Now, during this summer, you're going to have a lot of time. You'll have your summer vacation. You won't have school every day. But what will you do with all of your time during the summer? I'm sure that oftentimes you will sleep in. You will have the opportunity to relax after a long school year. But I hope that you will also, and especially, be faithful in your daily prayer life, that you will never let a day pass without praying your morning prayers, your night prayers, and especially the daily rosary, as Our Lady asked. But also to say extra prayers, to make up for those who do not love our Lord, and who offend Him by the way they live. This consoles our Lord very much when we do our part to make up for those who do not love Him. When we say extra prayers, when we tell our Lord that we love Him, when we make the sacrifice needed to obey our parents, to be faithful to the commandments, to do our daily duties, even when we don't feel like it. And we do that out of love for our Lord. Our Lord certainly proved His love for us. As He Himself said, "No greater love does a man have than to lay down his life for his friends." So we look at the crucifix over the altar and we think about our Lord dying on the cross. And this is how He showed His love for us. He didn't just say it, that He loved us, and He does love us, but He proved it by dying for us. And we also prove our love for our Lord when we make sacrifices, when we do things that are hard, when we give up our own desires, our own will, to say our prayers, when we are obedient to His commandments. This consoles our Lord. And our Lord wanted to make sure there was no room for any doubt of His love for us. And so He willed that after He died on the cross, a soldier came with a lance and pierced His side with the lance to prove that He was dead. And the sword point, the point of the lance, pierced His heart. And the last blood in His body flowed out of His heart, out of that wound in His side, and flowed out of His body. He wanted to show us that He gave everything. And maybe He wanted His heart to be pierced so that it would be open, you might say, so that we can enter into His heart. By our love for our Lord, you might say, we are united with Him, with His sacred heart. Let us then do our part to make reparation, to be like the Fatima children, and like all of the saints, those who, the young saints, like St. Dominic Savio, St. Maria Goretti, and so many others who were your age and served our Lord and were conscientious in fulfilling their duties. And they did it also out of love for our Lord. Let us listen to his words to St. Margaret Mary, that behold the heart that has loved man so much and is so little loved in return. Let us at least love him and prove it by how we live. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.